Listen.
Don't you know that you got me?
Right?
That you got me in me. Got me so
I like it. Hey everybody, welcome back to Dame Bramage Rocks channel. All right, time to divert from my regularly scheduled program and continue on the little journey we're having with the Eurovision Song Contest at 2024. If this is your first time to the channel, number one, welcome. This is a rock and hard rock based channel, but I do bands from all around the world, and I do like to cover the Eurovision Song Contest because I'm absolutely fascinated by it and having a really, really good time. And today I wanted to cover the submission from Malta. I covered Malta last year, and I've actually been there. And I love the little country. The people were a lot of fun. I had a really, really good time there. And to be honest, last year's submission, the Busker with Dance Our Own Party, was to me was like the dark horse of the contest. And that band, when they performed it live on stage, did a phenomenal job. It's got a great little saxophone hook there. And it was still one of my favorite submissions, although it was not widely popular with the rest of, you know, the contest, the judges, and the popular vote, and to even make it to the finals. But to me, it is still one of my favorites, and I still actually have it on a playlist that I use there. So I wanted to check out Malta again strictly for that reason, because I just dig the country and I want to support them all I can. So this one, this year, the singer, her name is Sarah Bonici, and the song is called Loop. And again, this is Malta's national final performance. So this one's done live. So this is going to be phenomenal because we're going to kind of get an idea of how she sounds live. And this is their submission to the Eurovision Song Contest 2024. Stick around after the reaction because I want to learn more about Sarah and what this song is and her entry into the Eurovision Song Contest of 2024 during the wrap up. Without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into this one. Sarah Bonici, the song Loop, national final performance, Malta submission to the Eurovision Song Contest of 2024. Here we go. All right, so here's what I just found. I found the official music video as well. So we're going to do both. But I want to start with the official music video. I know we said we're going to do the national light performance. I'm going to do that one after this. So let's go ahead and listen to Sarah Bonici and the song Loop, the official music video, and then we'll do the live performance that way so we can see how she sounds in the studio production and see how she looks live. So Sarah Bonici, Loop, official music video. Here we go.
Don't you know that you got me? That you got me in me. Got me so high, burning up like a fever. I'm a honey pot, never tasted nothing sweeter. Thought you could turn me down.
Okay, not bad. It's Eurovision worthy. It's a pop song, you know, and we see a lot of these come through the contest, especially in more recent years up to the last decade there. But you got a few different genres I'm catching. You got R&B, definitely got a big pop heavy sound to this one there. You got a little bit of salsa mixed in with it. So I'm catching like Shakira vibes, especially with the way she dances in this as well. So yeah, very, very interesting. you know, not obviously the staple of this channel because this is a hard rock and rock heavy channel, but Eurovision Song Contest, so I'm here for all of it. And I love Malta. And like I said, the one from last year, I'll be honest, nothing really, really driving out of me hardcore right at the moment. It just sounds like another pop song. But I know Malta is very, very small, very, very small, and they do not have a lot to pick from. So with that being said, gorgeous lady for sure. Phenomenal voice, not denying that at all. Great, great dancer. Awesome. Like hitting all those things. So for to have this represent Malta is a really, really good submission. Not my typical line of music. So far, the lyrics aren't catching me, but we're going to hear the live version as well. So that might change my mind right now. But it just sounds, you know, it's just, yeah, it's a good beat, typical pop R&B song. You know, a little bit of Shakira vibes in it. Yeah, all right. You know, why not? Beautiful voice. Okay. Huh. Oh my God, you got that. Yeah, I actually didn't mind. Yeah, you know, had a little good electronic, you know, heavy bass beat back there. Not bad. It does seem like your run-of-the-mill pop and R&B song, you know, that we've been hearing for years and years. Again, Shakira vibes strongly in that one, but she's a great dancer. That's super fun. I do like those, like, sharp, you know, hip kind of salsa dance moves that they got going on there. Not bad. Not bad at all. But I'm really, really curious to see how this performs live, because she's a really, really good dancer. And if you can put on a phenomenal stage presence, you're going to pump that crowd up. And that's where you're going to get, you know, those views and those votes and those listens for sure. And this is going to resonate with a lot of people because, you know, Eurovision is very pop and R&B heavy for sure. I'm sorry. Yeah, pop and R&B heavy there. And so this will catch it a lot. But just, you know, lyrically didn't really, nothing that really stood out to me so far, but let's listen to live because I'm really curious to see how they're going to perform this on stage, and this is probably going to be really, really good. I'm excited for it. Stand by for 1 second. All right, so this is the national final performance, and they had the Malta selection contest, so this is the performance from that. So this should be very, very good because, you know, this was the performance from that there, and I'm excited to see how she translates this on stage and see how her voice sounds live. Don't you know that you got me, that you got me, yeah, me. Okay. It got me so high, burning up like a fever. I already like it better because I like how she brought out that classic harshness in her voice in the beginning from like the 70s, you know, the 60s and 70s R&B female singers there. Just that harshness in the tone of her voice already, I like it a lot better. Listen. Don't you know that you got me? Right? That you got me. Yeah, me. It got me so I like it. Burning up like a fever. I'm a honey pot. Never tasted nothing sweeter. Turn me down. I like this. No, let's go another round. Slow. Don't you tell me I'm your addiction. It was obvious you'd end up like this. Not my fault.
all that you got, got me on. I'm a lamb with a better things on.
I dig the choreography.
I'm a teaser, no catch. You love it when I'm
cherry on top of cinnamon.
You know how to spin me, boy. Don't you know you're my addiction? It was obvious we end up like this. Not my fault that you got me on.
All right, this is catching me a little bit better. I'm digging this way more than I like the music video. The choreography is phenomenal. These dancers kick ass. I'll tell you what. You just saw, I think that was a lady that just did a front flip there. That was phenomenal. But I'm digging the choreography. Her voice sounds better live. They should have just kept with that during the music video because I love that harshness that's coming out in her vocals here. And the choreography is good. Much, much better production than the video for sure. Now I can see why this could catch on and be a good contender in the Eurovision Song Contest.
Not my fault that you got me on.
Woo! Look at him go. I'm a lamb with a baby, baby, baby. I apologize. The backup dancers are all guys. That was, not a female.
I'm a lamb with a baby, 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 so. I'm a tease and no catch. You love it when I move, 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 move.
Okay, blindfolded. Ooh, fun. Not bad.
It was obvious we're addicted. Yeah, it was obvious. Here we go.
Much better. So when they did that in the music video, it was pitchy. It was all over the place. It was just like up, down, left, right. Like I did not dig that part in the music video. She sounds so much better live than she does in the studio. This good. That's good. This is going to carry weight in the contest. And again, the choreography, fun, super fun.
Here we go.
Okay. Nice.
I'm a lamb with a better bear things on. I'm a tease and no catch. You love it when I move. In your head all night, you got me on. Got me on. Got me on loo.
All right, that was fun. That if that translates to the actual stage performance when they go, that's good. That's going to be a lot of fun. That was way better than the music video. So kind of jumped up a few tiers on that ladder there for sure. But stick around for a few minutes. Let's find out who Sarah is. All right, everybody, welcome back. That was Sarah Bonici with her song Loop, Malta's submission to the Eurovision Song Contest of 2024. Jump on over to the Eurovision.tv website because you can get all the information you can possibly want about the artist here. So, Sarah Bonici, growing up in a highly musical family, Sarah's passion for the arts was discovered at a very young age. We've heard this a lot this year, actually. There's a lot of influences on the singers who made it to this year's contest. In 2009, Sarah made her debut in the Malta Junior Euro Song, finishing third overall. Awesome. The following year, she joined the Maltese delegation as a backup singer and dancer to Junior Eurovision in Belarus. Throughout the year, Sarah has headlined major festivals and events and has been invited to perform on international stages all across Europe. Sarah co-wrote Loop with Eurovision Song Contest 2015 winning writers Lene Deb and Joy Deb, together with Lier Gotexi Angel, and Sebastian Pricard James, Kevin Lee, and Michael Joe Cini. And down here, they got the lyrics to Loop right there. But moving on to All About Sarah, Lookout Malmo. Maltese Sarah Bonici is headed to the Eurovision Song Contest 2024 with her song Loop, and she's making some serious moves. Before winning her place in Eurovision Song Contest, Sarah Bonici had won, had to win over Maltese first, and she did. She spun into Malta's national final with the black cat suit, vocal prowess, and some very spicy dancing. After the jury and public vote, she finished with a strong lead. Sarah has had vocal lessons from Miriam Christine, who was Malta's Eurovision entry in 1996, performing in All Women's Heart at the contest in Oslo. Miriam encouraged Sarah to take part in the competition herself, and from there she went on to take third place in the Malta Junior Eurovision Eurosong in 2029. Sarah has a star-studded songwriting team for Loop and has also been part of the artistry. Lene Deb and Joy Deb are well known for the world of Eurovision, having written Mons, Zolomir's Heroes, which won the contest for Sweden in 2015. Michael Josini, known as Missy Mago, co-wrote Malta's 2023 entry for the Busker Dance Our Own Party, which was still one of my favorite songs from this mission last year altogether. And for Kevin Lee, this will be his fifth time working behind the scenes at the Eurovision Song Contest in some form or another. They joined by Lier Goxi, Angel Sebastian Pricard James, who started as street performers and have now racked up over 9 million streams on their tracks. Fantastic. The weirdest place Sarah has ever performed is a kitchen, which might be the extreme opposite of Eurovision stage. She's also headlined major festivals and events, and now she can add the great music competition on earth. Cheering Sarah from home will be her King Charles Spaniel dog Lily and her Persian cat Spice, who she adopted. We hope she'll be able to schedule in a few FaceTimes with them while in Malmo to punctuate those long days. Sarah's favorite Eurovision entry is Sam Ryder's Spaceman for United Kingdom in 2022. That was a hugely, insanely huge popular song, which finished second in place of Ukraine's Kalush Orchestra, which was also a super fun song. She loves Sam's song and his energy. We can get a Sarah and Sam collab, please. Another of her favorite songs is Cornelia Jacobs' Hold Me Closer, which got fourth place at Eurovision 2022. Other songs she's playing in on loop are Dua Lipa's Houdini, Beyonce's Crazy in Love, and Miley Cyrus's Flowers. She might love current pop hits with strong female vocals, but she's also got some classic on repeat. Sarah is a big fan of Aretha Franklin's Say a Little Prayer, Stevie Wonder's Wish, and Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody. See, and that's what I alluded to at the beginning of the live version, that harsh-speed ratchetness voice from those like old classic R&B singers like Aretha Franklin. You definitely heard it come out there. After Sarah won the Maltese selection competition, she said, "I am just speechless and truly genuine, very happy. This has always been my dream, so now my dream came true. There is room for more dreams yet, Sarah. Look out, Sarah, an upcoming episode in the official Eurovision Song Contest podcast." Congratulations, Sarah and Malta, for that submission there. I like the live version. I think that's going to translate very well to the stage, and I do wish her well in that contest. And I've always got Malta in my back corner. I love the country. The people there are so much fun, and it's a really, really cool, very, very small place. And if you try to look up on a map, you got to zoom way in just to catch that little tiny island that's sitting there in the middle of the ocean just below Italy. So aside from that, what did you all think about that? What do you think about the Eurovision Song Contest? What do you think about Sarah and her submission Loop and Malta's submission to the Eurovision Song Contest 2024? What do you think about the reaction? Leave all those comments below. I like to read and interact with as many of you as possible and learn all the things I can learn about that. But anything about the videos, about the songs, and about Sarah, I will go ahead and leave links for down below here for you in this video, so you can go ahead and catch onto her or watch those videos all by themselves there. And on top of that, any of these icons you see over here, these are my social media links. I will leave those links for down below. So if you want to follow me in these extra channels or socials, those links are down there as well. All the information is provided for you in a necessary, easy to find spot in the video description of this video. All right, y'all, this is your first time on the channel. Number one, welcome. Number two, dig around the channel. I have a couple playlists now, the Eurovision Song Contest being a big one. I did a lot of reactions from last year's, and I'm doing a lot of reactions from this year, and this will carry on into the future there. And if you like what you see, do those things for me. At the very minimum, everyone watching, if you like what you just saw, at least hit that like button for me. It does help this video significantly, and I truly, truly appreciate it. One more time, everyone, Sarah Bonici, her song Loop, Malta's submission to the Eurovision Song Contest of 2024. I hope you all have an amazing day, and until next time, keep on rocking. Metal eyes so we can see. I have no injuries.
say.